Hi and welcome. My name is Marcia Teal and I'm an executive with HCR Manor Cares Art and Courts Alzheimer's Assisted Living. We are a proven leader in the field nationwide when it comes down to Alzheimer's and dementia care. I'm your guest host today on Think Strong, and I'm glad you're with us because we have a wonderful show for you. Today, Dr. Mark Brody, a neurologist and researcher from Brain Matters Research in Delray Beach, Florida, will be joining us and telling us on something he calls a puff of smoke. I'm so honored to be here with you today and to learn a little bit more about what Alzheimer's is all about. We have caregivers and families out there that really need to understand what it's going on with their loved one, and education is the key. So I'm curious, you mentioned that it's called a puff of smoke, but I'm not sure what you mean by that. Can you explain?
Well, this is exciting. This notion of a puff of smoke is the idea that when we can see just a puff of smoke, where before the disease really gets any momentum, you know that old expression, where there's smoke, there's fire, where there's a puff of smoke, well, there's already something smoldering. So if we can pick up this disease very early and see the puff of smoke and intervene then, especially now that we have a number of promising new investigational drugs here at Brain Matters Research and throughout the country, that maybe we could stop this disease in its tracks. And if we also were able to identify high-risk individuals before they got the disease, the holy grail would be that we could see these plaques forming in the brain, and we might be able to do a blood test or some specific markers in the spinal fluid and treat these people before they ever got a symptom.
But that's the problem that I see a lot of families that probably have had these puffs of smoke,
right,
but they're not doing anything about it until maybe later on, and then they look back and say, aha, now that's makes sense to me what was going on. So with this information, what should people be looking for to be their trigger and say, ah, that's a puff of smoke, I need to do something about it?
Right. Well, one thing I want to say is sometimes, you know, a lot of people, like the river that goes through Egypt, are in denial.
Mm-hmm.
And they don't want to know.
That's true.
Okay. And some don't want to know because they don't think there's anything to do about it, or they're just afraid. And I can understand that. But there is something to do, and there is hope out there, and that's really, you know, our mission. Brain Matters Research, now, you know, we're the largest private Alzheimer's research center in the country, and our mission really is to give substance to hope. And there is hope out there. There is a light at the end of the tunnel, and we are seeing people that have been in open-label investigation drugs. That means we didn't know what they were getting initially, but then everybody gets the real drug. And they've stabilized over 2.5 to 3 years, which is really unheard of. Because everybody gets worse and everybody succumbs.
Yeah.
But getting back to your question, if you're concerned and your loved ones are the ones that are going to know when there's a difference, when you're forgetful, when you have been doing your bank book and now you miss payments, you're having trouble with arithmetic, you can't find your wallet, you can't find your keys, you don't remember where your car was parked.
Yeah, but I forget some of that. I forget where I parked my car.
I know, but I've screened you, Marcia. You're okay.
Oh, okay.
You have dreams, goals for the future. What if they were stolen from you by Alzheimer's? Every 71 seconds, someone develops this cruel disease, potentially crippling Medicare in the near future. The Alzheimer's Association is taking action and has been a part of every major advancement. but we won't rest until we have a cure. You have dreams. Help the Alzheimer's Association protect them. To learn more, go to alz.org.
But seriously, people do forget those kinds of things, but that doesn't necessarily mean you're on the verge of getting Alzheimer's, does it?
Right. And sometimes early, it's hard to know. Mm-hmm. But if you're concerned, if you as a person are concerned, or if your loved ones are telling you things, like a lot of people down here have kids up in the Northeast, and they'll call me or they'll get on our website and say, you know what, I talked to Mom about this 2 weeks ago. She's asking me the same questions again. Mm-hmm. So asking questions repeatedly about material that you covered recently.
That's a sign.
That's a puff of smoke.
Okay, that's
losing
a puff of
keys,
smoke.
Can't find the words.
Putting the iron in the freezer because you forget that it goes in the closet, that kind of thing.
Yeah, unless you keep it in the freezer normally. But the point is this, people around you see a puff of smoke. And what you need to know is, I think, at this point, we can help you. And I want to tell you about a puff of smoke study and some of these new terms. There's something called MCI, mild cognitive impairment. Not the stock, because they're bankrupt. But the point is this. We used to say this is pre-Alzheimer's, and we've called this now prodromal Alzheimer's. And this category, there's normal brain aging. Mm-hmm. Everything slows down a little bit. Everybody's a little forgetful. But, you know, you can't remember a name. It comes back to you in an hour. So.
Right. Think about it.
So that happens. Definitely happens to me. But mild cognitive impairment means you do have a little trouble with short-term memory. And you're not quite as clear as you used to be. But you basically can do everything that you could normally do.
Maybe just a little slower, right?
But, I mean, you can go get groceries and look after your bank book. And you're functional.
Okay.
Now, in that segment, there are 70% of those people are at high risk to evolve into early Alzheimer's. And there's a segment of them called prodromal Alzheimer's. They're the puff of smoke people. And it's only been in the last few months that there are studies designed to identify those people and treat them early before the disease gets
really
momentum.
Really? That's cutting edge.
That is cutting edge. And it's very clear that if we're going to intervene, the earlier the better, because this is a disease, is a train on a track. Unless you get people early, it's very hard to make a significant impact. So we're very excited about this. We're one of the few centers in the country involved with this. So when we see this puff of smoke, because we're looking, we do this every day, we see the early changes with the psychometric testing and the PET scans of the brain where we see early changes in the metabolism of the lobes of the brain that are involved with memory and thinking. And we actually now take some spinal fluid out and analyze it for this beta amyloid, these plaques that are forming and these tau proteins. We have good correlation now that this is a very sensitive measurement and specific for early Alzheimer's.
Well, let me ask you this. Is every person who has beginning stages or pre-Alzheimer's, is everyone a candidate for research?
No.
No.
No. Research is, what does research mean? Research means that, and for the most part, what we do here is pharmaceutical-sponsored clinical research. That means the various pharmaceutical companies, and every small, medium, and large pharmaceutical companies are looking for a treatment for Alzheimer's. So all this research is free. So
it's free.
It's free. So
does it cost the patient anything?
Nothing.
Wonderful.
So, I mean, free is a good price.
That's
now, of course, at the end, when the pharmaceutical company comes up with a treatment, then of course they're going to charge you. But the point is this: sometimes when we test you, we'll say, you know what, this puff of smoke is not a puff of smoke that looks like early Alzheimer's prodromal. There's some reassurance. You've got some benign memory loss. You're getting older. You're unlikely to cross over to this threshold of early Alzheimer's and all the things that